During his call, the infamous phone call that Donald Trump had with Georgia's Republican Secretary of State, Brad Raffensperger, in addition to, of course, telling him to go find the votes, which is now the subject of a grand jury investigation, Donald Trump also told Raffensperger that, listen, I lost the state by roughly 11,000 votes. Well, guess what? You had at least, that we know of, 5,000 dead people that voted in your state in 2020. 5,000 people rose from the grave to vote in Georgia in the 2020 election. And as ridiculous as that claim is, even the Republican officials in Georgia who didn't want to go along with Trump's election lies still said, oh, wow, 5,000 people. We got to investigate this. And investigate it they did. They looked into all of these claims of dead people voting throughout the state, the 5,000 that Trump and his people said existed. And after a nearly year-long investigation, the state of Georgia did, in fact, find those dead voters. Except they didn't find five of them. 5,000, they found four. Not 4,000, four. One, two, three, four dead voters who cast a ballot last year in Georgia. And by golly, wouldn't you know it? You want to guess what party they were for? You want to guess? I think we all know. They were Republicans. Now, they were also recently deceased. However, they were deceased before, of course, these mail-in ballots were sent to them. So obviously, you know, you can't try to argue like, no, they filled the ballot out and signed it, and then they died, so I went ahead and sent it back. Because I actually think you're in a bit of a legal gray area if that were the case, right? If somebody requested a ballot, gets it, fills it out, signs it, but is unable to mail it back in because they die in between the two, I'm going to tell you, I still think that vote should be counted. Legal gray area, of course, but again, that's not even what we're dealing with here. Here's one particular story from the Atlanta Journal-Constitution. In one case, a 74-year-old widow submitted an absentee ballot on behalf of her husband, William Nelson, after he died in September of 2020. He was going to vote Republican, and she said, well, I'm going to cancel your ballot because I'm voting Democrat. It was kind of a joke between them. Barry Bishop, an attorney for Sharon Nelson of Canton, told the state election board, she received the absentee ballot, carried out his wishes. She now realizes that was not the thing to do. So, okay, that was a Democrat voting for a Republican because her dead husband was a Republican, and whatever. Remorse is something we hear a lot, and it's something I appreciate because sometimes we do make these mistakes unknowingly. It's from a member of the state election board. Right, okay, well, iffy. In another case, a ballot was submitted for deceased Augusta voter Leon Rowe. Investigators found that the signature on his absentee ballot envelope matched the handwriting of his mother, Aileen Rowe, who died in October of 2020. So, yeah. Four. Not 5,000. Not 4,000. Not 1,000. Not even 10. Not even 5. But four cases of dead people voting in the state of Georgia in 2020. Certainly not enough to change Biden's electoral victory of 11,000 votes. It is what it is. Donald Trump keeps being proven wrong at every possible turn, every audit, every investigation, every recount, every verification step along the way has proven that Donald Trump and his idiot followers are lying about the 2020 election being stolen. And none of it matters to the people making those claims. They will continue to say these things that we know are false, that investigations have proven are false, because they don't want facts to get in the way of their feelings.